This video is my second central limit theorem example. IQ scores have a mean of 100 and a variance of 225. If a random sample of 50 people is selected, what is the probability that the sample mean is between 99 and 102? So the clue that I'm using the central limit theorem is this part here. It says the probability the sample mean. Okay, so I want a probability corresponding to a sample mean, not an individual IQ score. So here's what we're given. We're given that the mean of IQ scores, the mean of the original distribution of individual values, is 100. The variance, sigma squared, is 225. And we're going to need the standard deviation to find the standard error of the mean. So remember, the relationship between the variance and the standard deviation is that the standard deviation is the square root of the variance. So sigma will be equal to 15 because the square root of 225 is 15. In probability notation, we're finding the probability that x bar falls between 99 and 102. Okay, so I'm not putting x here, where x would represent an individual IQ score. I'm putting x bar, the sample mean based on a sample size of 50. So the central limit theorem says that x bar, if the sample size is at least 30, will be normally distributed with a mean the same as the original population. So mu sub x bar is equal to mu. So mu sub x bar for this example is 100, but the standard deviation of the sample means is smaller. Specifically, that standard deviation is equal to the standard deviation of the original population divided by the square root of n. This is the standard error of the mean, and this is what you need to use if you want to use your z-table to find the probability and convert to a z-score. You're going to need to divide that denominator by this rather than 15. All right, so I want to sketch the area that I'm looking for. Again, x bar will be normally distributed with a mean of 100, and I'm going from 99 up to 102. And I want a shade in between. Now, rather than standardize each of these endpoints and use the z-table, I'm going to use my calculator. Going to my normal CDF function. My lower bound is 99. My upper bound is 102. Mu is 100. And sigma is 15 divided by the square root of 50. I could have found 15 divided by the square root of 50 here and rounded to, say, 4 decimal places and typed that in here. But what's nice about the calculator is that for this part, you can just put in the expression as is. You don't have to do this calculation separately. And then enter. And that area or probability rounded to 4 decimal places, that's going to be 0.5084. All right, so one thing to keep in mind is that this is not finding the probability that you randomly select a single IQ score between 99 and 102. This is the probability of getting a sample mean between 99 and 102 based on a sample size of 50. So for comparison, we could look at what is the probability of getting an individual IQ score between 99 and 102. To do that, I have to now assume that IQs are normally distributed. Okay, so again, we're finding the area corresponding to the same endpoints, But this time I'm finding the probability corresponding to an individual x value. So I don't want to use x bar for my notation, I want to use x. Now, I'm looking at the distribution for x. I don't want to use the standard error of the mean for that standard deviation. I want to use 100 and I want to use 15 for mu and sigma respectively. So going back to my distribution menu, my lower bound, upper bound are the same, but I'm going to change that standard deviation. And then I get, now I clearly did not draw this proportionally correct, and that's okay. I'm just treating this as a visual aid. All right, so looking at this area or probability, 0.0796, and comparing it to the probability we get a sample mean between 99 and 102, clearly these aren't the same. Okay, you are more likely to get a sample mean between these two values for a group of 50 than an individual IQ between 99 and 102. So pay attention to the wording of a problem. If you are asked a probability corresponding to a sample mean, you're going to be using the central limit theorem, and you'll want to make sure you use this as your standard deviation.